Hi, this is SHARE S20. In my previous video, I have already tested the performance of the RTK GPS receiver. And in this video, I'm going to test the tracking performance of SHARE S20 by using the SLAM algorithm. S20 has higher precision IMU sensor than the SHARE C1, and it also has the visual SLAM, a very small camera used for tracking the repeat pattern. And if you look in the mobile app, so there is a vision camera here. We tap here, it just say status is normal. You can't see the preview of this camera on the live screen when you are making the 3D scan. There is no way to know that this camera is working unless I do the test, which is I will show you in this video. So SHARE S20, it has four tracking mechanism. One is the RTK, the LiDAR, IMU sensor, and a visual SLAM. And for the SHARE C1, only has the LiDAR and the IMU sensor. It's only two for the SHARE C1, but the tracking performance is very, very good. Okay, this will be the hotel corridor that I will use for testing. Corridor is quite narrow. It's only 1.6 meter in the width. For the length, from one end to one end, it's 44 meter. So I'm going to start in the hallway. I'm going to walk like this. And I'm going to pass to another three floors using this stair. Because the corridor is quite narrow, many of the LiDAR scanner will have a rotational drift. So I'm going to walk up three floors. If the LiDAR scanner has a drifting order, the height between the floor to floor here will be different. For the scenario like this, I think most of the LiDAR scanner will have a drifting order, so the edge will have a different value because the corridor is really long, 44 meters, extremely narrow, 1.6 meters. And for the visual SLAM, there's going to be the door on the side wall here, but the door is spaced with the repeat pattern. Walk from one point to the second point here, it's going to see the same pattern. This is the same pattern. Many LiDAR scanner will lose the track immediately. C1 doesn't have the visual SLAM sensor. I didn't bring it along with me to do the test, so I cannot tell if the C1 can still track with the repeat pattern comparing to the S20. I will start in the elevator hallway, which is the largest space on this floor. When I turn into the corridor, I will stop for a few seconds, allow the scanner to capture the image in front of it. The lighting condition is quite dim, and the maximum speed that I can walk is less than 1 meter per second. If the corridor is curved, it will be easier for the scanner to track. But this one is simple straight line. The end of the corridor has a glass window, so it's not possible for the LiDAR to track the distance along the length of the corridor. travel distance is 320 meters in about 9 minutes. I forgot to put the mark on the floor, so the start and the end point is about 60 centimeters apart. I put it in the long spot. And when you look in the preview screen, the floor on the left wing, far left, it's not parallel between the second and the third floor. It's not parallel. Let's see if the SLAM algorithm can fix this. But there is no tracking loss during the scan. Okay, this is the result from the S20. Corridor scanning for three floors. They look parallel. Okay, let me slide this. Click on save. Okay, this will be the second clipping. Click on save. C-axis distance is 2.987, 2.973, so the floor-to-floor height difference is only 14 millimeters. Okay, let's check the left wing. The left wing is quite long from the hallway. The distance is longer, 2.968, 2.984. So the difference on the left wing is 16 millimeter. I can confirm that the floors on the second, third, and fourth floor are parallel. The maximum error of the floor-to-floor height is only 16 millimeter, which is very, very small for the building about this long. Okay, let's check the scan quality in the first person view. The elevator door is reflective, it's chrome color. I can see the texture of the marble. If you look at the room number, I walked past this spot three times. The camera is captured this side of the wall with the numbers more than three times, right? And it aligned the letters very accurate. Every certain length, the door pattern will repeat. I have tested many LiDAR scanners to start losing the track as soon as it detects the same pattern. So I need to put like a chair, a large carton box on the floor to make the feature for the scanner to track. The width of the corridor is 1.5 meter. Okay, so the color point cloud quality is quite good. If you can look at the pictures, this is not even a 3DGS. This is color point cloud. And when you open this in AutoCAD, you are going to see the same result, because the SHARE Studio, they don't have a transparent mode when displaying the point cloud. So you are going to see the same quality as you see it here in the software. Okay, so the quality of the wall texture is the same. The sharpness of the text on the third floor is also the same. In the second test, I make a 3D scan of this small shopping mall. I start here and I walk along the corridor. And then I walk up to the second floor. Thank you. I need to rotate the clipping tools, and then I'm gonna clip it like this, and then I'm going to measure the floor to floor between the left wing and the right wing. The first one is 3.548, the second one is 3.552 4 millimeters. So the difference in the floor to floor height between the left wing and the right wing is 4 millimeters. So this is the very accurate LiDAR scanner. There's no drifting on the Z axis. Super parallel. It's the same level as the total station. Before I start the 3D scan, I already checked that this building was built using a post-tension floor system. Usually they have a very high accurate when they build this type of the floors, a higher precision than the normal suspension floor that placed on the concrete beam. Okay, look at the car. Look at the car, it's very good. Quality of the color point cloud is very good. Window frame is quite clear. You can measure 3.48. Is that in Chinese? What they put the sign Chinese? But this is Thailand. The sign is in Chinese. This one too. It's a car rental? No. Why they put this in Chinese? And then I walk here. Let's speed up a bit. Okay, this will be the second floor. Yeah, the sign is quite clear, and I noticed that the LED color is very saturated for the SHARE S20. I think this is Japanese, the sign. Let's go here. Okay, the umbrella detail is quite good. I mean, look at this. All right, I think it's depend on the reflectivity of the surface. If the surface has a high reflectivity, it's going to give a denser point cloud like these letters here. This karaoke. Let's look from the top. Okay, so this will be my third review of the SHARE S20, testing the SLAM and the visual SLAM performance, and the result turned out very accurate. Thanks you guys for watching. I see you in the next video.